Imagine you're walking through the park and you see a bunch of birds hanging out in a tree. One of them begins to sing, and quickly you locate the bird that is singing and identify it as a sparrow. Have you ever stopped to wonder how you did that? First you heard a noise, then you used your eyes to locate the source of that noise, and then you identified the producer of the song as a sparrow. That interaction of sight and sound is what my research focuses on. We know that the eyes and the ears send information to the brain in great detail, but it's just as important to know how the brain sends information from more than one sense, how that information is joined together and interpreted in the brain. It turns out that there are cells in the brain that do respond directly to information from more than one sense. We call these cells multisensory, and I'm working on finding out how exactly they process that sensory information. Some multisensory cells have enhanced responses to this multisensory information. Some cells do not, and I'm working on figuring out why. This is a question broader than, how is multisensory information processed? What I'm really interested in is how do neural circuits develop and function? And I'm using the tools of sensory processing in tadpoles to figure this out. Tadpoles have simpler brains than humans and other vertebrates, and that allows me to study their neural circuits in great detail. I'm using a really cool technique to study these circuits. And I'm actually watching a living neural circuit by taking over 20 images a second of these cells. These cells light up because I've added a dye that lights up when calcium is present. And calcium is very closely correlated with neural activity and therefore serves as a good proxy. By quantifying this lighting up, I can find out if the cells respond to information just from the eyes, just from the ears, or both. And if they respond to both, do they have enhanced responses to multisensory stimuli? So far, I have found that individual cells have different responses to the same stimulus. Previously, we had thought that multisensory properties arose from responses to weaker and stronger stimuli in the same cell. But my research shows that this same multisensory property holds true across a neural circuit for a single stimulus. Right now, I am following up on what sort of single cell properties could give rise to this network and behavior level property. In particular, we have found a single protein that is required. It is called the NMDA type glutamate receptor, well known for its role in learning and memory, integrates information in neurons. Therefore, our working hypothesis is that the information from the eyes and the ears is integrated in each neuron, and that integrated signal adds up to more than the sum of the parts in the network. Then that large network signal is used by the tadpole to generate behavior. However, beyond this, my results have been somewhat ambiguous. Thus is the challenge of science, to keep asking questions and doing experiments until the answer becomes clear. Some of you may feel a bit lost, and that's okay. Scientific discovery is rarely linear, hardly ever makes sense the first time, and requires a lot of hard work. This is often hidden by the summary that you see online or in the newspaper. My results and this method of studying living neural circuits is part of a broader, larger line of scientific inquiry called basic science. Basic science results and innovations underlie all translational experiments, all treatments for human disease. These basic science questions help us to find out what the normally behaving animals and neural circuits are doing, because we need to know what normal looks like before we can begin to understand disease states. Now bring yourself back to to the sensory experience of the sparrow. A question that seemed simple, how do we interpret the world using our senses, seems much more complex now. The neurons, the neural circuits, and the methods of scientific inquiry all go into figuring out what our brains are doing. And while this may now seem like an insurmountable task, with the hard work and collaboration of researchers like me, we can do it. Thank you.